So high tunnels are difficult and time consuming to build. From start to finish, you may spend 80 to 100 hours building your high tunnel. When you first get your high tunnel, you should start by reading the directions. These are complicated structures to put together, so take the time to read the directions, make extra copies so that you can take the directions out into the field. Then, after you've read the directions, go out and unpack all of your boxes. Inventory that all the parts are there and divide and group them so that when you start assembling, it's very easy to go out and find the individual pieces from the piles. Then go out and mark and install your four corner post. It is absolutely critical to make sure you get the four corner post perfectly square in line with each other. So we can use the math formula, a squared plus b squared equals the hypotenuse squared. So if we set this as our ground post, and then we look down the line here, that would be our a squared, so a squared. And then we go from that ground post again over to that end. That would be our b squared on our triangle. And if we take a squared plus b squared, that will equal c squared, or the hypotenuse of the triangle. And if a squared plus b squared equals c squared, we know we have a square high tunnel. Well, as you're putting in the end post, you may want to consider putting cement down in the holes to hold those posts in place, particularly on windy conditions. Once the corner posts are in, then you go ahead and start spacing out your line post and driving those into the ground, or augering holes and cementing those posts into the ground. Again, under windy locations, we do recommend that you cement the ground post in. So these are the ground posts. These are buried probably 3 to 4 feet within the ground. You'll notice that this is a pretty solid structure. These are 4-inch diameter tubes. This thing is a very sturdy, well-built high tunnel. We have 4 feet from here to here. So 4 feet between our two ribs, going down the whole high tunnel. Once the ground posts are all in, make sure that they are perfectly lined up, just like with the corner post. Once they're all done and lined up, go ahead and start assembling the ribs for the high tunnel. This is best done on a hard surface, flat, open area where you have a lot of room to spread out. Get all the ribs assembled before you start putting them up onto the end post or the line post. Once all the ribs are assembled, one by one you can start taking them and placing them on top of the individual line post. Here it is helpful to have a couple ladders or possibly even a tractor and wagon to drive through the high tunnel as you're placing on the end post. If you look up on the rib post up here, you'll also see that it's bolted together. So they had to drill through and then apply the bolts through that structure. A lot of times you'll just see people use a small tech screw to kind of hold things together, and that's more common. These rib posts are much larger than what you normally find. You'll also see that this is a very tall structure. They put on extra height to this structure because they're going to be growing peaches in here, so we needed the extra elevation in order to grow the peaches up close to the sides of the high tunnel and be able to get 3 or 4 rows in here. So this is not what you would normally find, but it's a very nice high tunnel if you're going to be growing peaches or cherries. As you start getting a couple of those ribs in place, then you can start adding the substructure, or the purlins, to help hold everything together, and slowly start working your way across the high tunnel. And so these are our purlins that run from rib to rib going down throughout the structure. You'll see we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 purlins. Sometimes you'll find manufacturers that offer 4 purlins or 3 purlins going throughout the structure. Really, the more purlins, the more stability that you're gonna have on the structure. You're gonna prevent a lot of this back and forth by putting more of these purlins in. So if you go in and your manufacturer is giving you 3 purlins, spend the extra money, ask for them to give you an extra 1 or 2 purlins to string across the high tunnel. It will make a big difference as far as rigidity to that structure and its ability to hold up in wind. So here you have cables. And a lot of times you'll find cables strung through either on the corners like this or going across the structure as another way to provide additional support and strength to the high tunnel. So here we've got a cable, and we've got cable turnbuckles to tighten up. And here we have the cable turnbuckles, and we tighten those up. And again, it's just another way, just like the purlins, to hold the high tunnel firm and give it some support and structure for a fairly reasonable cost. Once you have the metal structure done, then you can go and start adding the wood components for the baseboards and the hip boards to start holding everything together and tightening everything up. This can be done, you know, within a few days after you get the metal structure put together. Here we have our baseboards, and you can see that they are bolted into the ribs of the high tunnel. Again, it's a 2x6, 2x8, depending on what your needs are. You'll notice that these are not treated boards that they're using here. That means these boards are going to have to be replaced, you know, 5-10 years down the road. What I do see people using a lot of times would be the plastic deck boards, and they will use those in direct replacement for the wood boards so that they don't ever have to replace them again. So we're looking at this baseboard. As you go down through here, that you should see that it is pretty much perfectly level going from one end to the next. The baseboard is directly perpendicular to our ground post and rib post here. Now you can start thinking about pulling across the polyethylene cover. When you're putting on the polyethylene cover, you want to make sure you've got a bunch of friends around to help. And you want to start very early in the morning, just at daybreak, when we have no wind. Take the cover, unroll it, use some strings and some tennis balls, and slowly pull and guide that polyethylene cover up over the structure. Once the polyethylene cover is pulled across the high tunnel and everything is buttoned down and tight, you can start assembling the end walls. The end walls can have lots of options. They can have wood, they can be polycarbonate based, they can be polyethylene based, just like your cover, or they can even be manufacturer supplied zipper end walls. You have a lot of different options when you're working with your end walls. Kind of the key though is to make sure that you can really open up those end walls and allow good air movement and ventilation through the high tunnel structure. Here we're looking at the end walls. We have two 2x6s, 2x8s stacked together for making a doorway. Let's see here. Our doorway is fairly tall. It's fairly wide. They want to be able to get in here with their large tractor and tiller to be able to work up the ground. And you'll see it's also fairly tall. Again, you want to be able to open up the end walls as much as possible to really push airflow through the structure. Granted, this is still under construction, but they'll likely have a vent up here right at the peak ridge. They'll likely have a vent there that'll open up. This door will open up, and then they'll likely have a people door somewhere right in here so that when they just need to run in and out during the early spring, early fall, or late fall, they just can open up that people door and come in. I also want to take a look at here. So we've got our irrigation water coming into the high tunnel, and they'll bring the water in. And then what they've got here is a electrical power supply. And so they'll use the electrical power supply. They'll have the irrigation manifold right here. They'll have a fertilizer injector plumbed in here. And then they'll have their filter and their pressure regulator will be all right down here on the ground once plants are in. So when they bought in the irrigation supply line and they trenched the line in, likely they bought in the electric supply with it as well, so that they're only trenching one time, one hole. So when putting together your high tunnel, take your time and follow the directions. Here we have a low tunnel. Low tunnels are a nice, inexpensive structure that we can place out in our garden or in our field. They provide us the ability to warm plants up faster and get them up growing faster than if we had just had them out just in the field.